Hello students, today I am here to explain F block elements. What are F block elements? The elements which have a partly filled F orbitals are called as F block elements. And these F block elements are classified into two, lanthanides and actinides. Let us discuss lanthanides. Here, the elements from lanthanum to lutetium that constitute a lanthanide series. The 14 elements which are next to the lanthanum are having a similar properties as that of the lanthanides. So these all the 15 elements are called as a lanthanides. And the first element that is the lanthanum, these lanthanides are called as the inner transition elements because as the atomic number increases, the electrons gets enter into the innermost F orbitals, so that they are called as a inner transition elements. Let's see the electronic configuration of it. Look at this slide. Here the lanthanides, electronic configuration of a lanthanides are given. So there are two ways of writing the electronic configuration of lanthanides. One which having only a outer 4f and 6s orbital, and one method consisting of outer 4f, 5d and 6s orbitals, except gadolinium and lutetium, because to attain the extra stability of acquiring a half filled and a completely filled electronic configuration. And what about the oxidation state of this? Here, most common and the principal oxidation state of lanthanides is a +3, but except few elements, or for some elements that exhibit +2, +4 and +5 electronic configuration, to attain extra stability by acquiring a exactly a filled and completely filled electronic configuration. Let us discuss the properties of the lanthanides. First property is the atomic radii. As we discussed in the case of D block elements, the atomic radii of, As we discussed in the D block elements, the atomic radii of lanthanides also decreases with the increases of atomic number. But here the decrease in atomic radii that is very small, or there is a small and steady decrease in atomic radii with the increases of atomic number takes place. So this small and steady decrease in size of the lanthanide with the increases of atomic number is called as a lanthanide contraction. But why this atomic radii decreases with the increases of atomic number? As the atomic number increases, the nuclear charge is also increases, so that there will be a greater attraction between the nuclei and the outermost electrons, so that the contraction takes place and the size decreases. And in case of a lanthanides, the atomic radii decreases or lanthanide contraction takes place because of a imperfect shielding of one 4f electron with the other electrons of the same subshell. And we can represent this lanthanide contraction by plotting a graph that is ionic radii versus atomic number. Here we can see the graph, will get this type of curve for the lanthanide contraction. From this graph we can conclude that there will be a very small decrease in the size of the lanthanide ions. For example, here La3+, that is the first element of the lanthanide series and it is the trivalent ion of a lanthanide, and that is having a ionic radii of 105, but then very next element Ce3 plus, that is having a ionic radii of 101. So that there is a very small decrease in the size of the ions takes place. After the lanthanide contraction, some changes that takes place. In case of electronegativity, similarity among the lanthanides, atomic radii and the basicity. That changes are called as the consequences of lanthanide contraction. Case of electronegativity, that is increases with the increases after the lanthanide contraction. Of course, this ionic radius that decreases, and also the basicity is also decreases, in the sense the basicity or a basic strength of lanthanides, that is from lanthanum to lutetium, decreases. So that lanthanum hydroxide is more basic than the other elements, and lutetium hydroxide, that is least basic in nature. And the similarity among the lanthanides, here there is a very steady decrease in the atomic size. Due to this reason, all the elements which have a similar size, so that it creates difficulties in their separation. Next property, that is the color of lanthanides. Here always the color of elements, that is depends upon the unpaired electrons present in it. Those elements which consist of unpaired electrons are colored, and those elements which consist of paired electrons are colorless. But the exact color of the element, that is depends upon the number of electrons present in it. And then complex formation tendency. Here in the case of d-block elements, they have a greater tendency to form the complexes because of their smaller size. But in case of lanthanides, they have a very poor tendency to form a complexes because of their larger size. But they form the complexes with a chelating ligand such as a EDTA. Next important property, that is the magnetic property. And here also the elements which consist of paired electrons, they are diamagnetic in nature, and those elements which consist of unpaired electrons are paramagnetic in nature. But in the case of d-block elements, we consider the spin motion of the electrons. The orbital motion of the electron gets quenched by the electrons of the ligands. So there, in case of d-block elements, the magnetic moment that can be calculated by using spin only formula, whereas in lanthanides, spin as well as the orbital motion of the electrons are considered, so that we can calculate the magnetic moment by using a formula root of 4s into s plus 1 plus l into l plus 1 Bohr magneton. Then what about the ionization energy? Due to the smaller size, the ionization energy is also decreases here. So that these are all the properties of lanthanides. Thank you.